This is Robert Hansen, 2018 gardening. I am asking and understanding of gardening things. Okay, I would like to know what you see, at least type and leave messages on here to where what you see and make us help us as well with making our garden as good as possible. Okay. Now you see here on this picture here, and you see the surrounding. Okay, plastic helps with moisture, water, and weed control, and some insects as well. Plus, with the mosquito situation, it helps with that, cause it keeps the water, keeps it all from. And we would like to know, have you had this done, and how did it work for you? Okay. Now, everyone has different ways of doing it, that's true. We would like to know how everyone does theirs to make sure that everyone, okay, there's farming communities, home farming, just the home farming. We would like to know and hear their ideals as well, learn from them, and we might have some ideals that no one has ever thought of. Okay. Now, you see this plant here. Look at the color. Okay. We got plastic and all that. Plastic is not good for for vines too much. Mounts don't do too good when it comes to doing it like this. So we learn from our mistakes, and we learn new things plus other things. Okay. And the type of soil as well. And you look for how the ground, if one ground sets higher than the other, but you want to set your property, your garden up to where somewhat the drainage can go right to your garden, help keeps the moisture in your garden, helps with the water, and plus it helps keeps the drainage where it helps with the mosquito population, keeps it down as well. Less water, just enough water, but not so much where the mosquitoes get real heavy in your yard. Okay? And you see a lot of different things going on. Like you can see a little plant starts up, it looks like, or tries to. And you can see the flowers and all that. And the thing of it is, remember, like certain plants, moist in your soil too, like your plant, what kind of, if it requires what is the HP level, soil, if your soil is hard, medium, or thin, thick, how thick it is, for comparison of your plant, because I found out that if your soil's, even when it gets wet and after it drains, if it gets real hard right back again, are your the roots of your plant able to handle that? And what climate too? Your climate, your weather, your climate of your zone and your soil. Because if you got a rocky soil, hard, or what kind of soil, and your pH level, okay. And if you got a wavy yard, okay. What kind of plants you have for your yard? What kind of garden are you planning to put up? Because if you want something that can handle your yard, like the amount of water, compare it with your soil, partial sun, with waviness, or however, and all that. But, yeah, and vines, and if it's a vine plant that you're growing, you might want to find out how far, how long can it go. And we made a growing box, my brother did, and he did this, and he used plastic as well. And it did pretty well. It lasted for 2 years. Now you're able to see it in other videos as in the ground. And by doing this, it helps. It was nice and rich soil in it too. Alright, and it's always best to have, if you can afford it, find out all what you can of your soil, okay? Like, I did not know about things about viruses, insects, and all that in areas as well. Because if your plant is like certain trees, if their roots don't reach far down and it's just an inch above ground, or 2 inches anyway, and good hard wind, and plus if your soil's not too thick to help hold the plant in place, then you might have problems. You can lose your trees and plants. And you always want to make sure your plants that you have, what kind they are, how far apart, how tall they get, how bushy, how wide did they get growing, what size, and all that. So you want to make sure, right, how much food it will acquire from the ground, plus your land is a little moisture, but it takes quite a bit of water for them, then you want to get them type of plants. And there's where where it's getting real dry outside, real hot, and you always want to make sure too, the water that you use, from what other people's told me on videos, that you want to make sure your water is the temperature outside, not cold, not hotter than what it is. The same temperature as outside. So you'll throw your plant off into shock or destroy it. And this is a way to, and you can, and this does do pretty good up to a certain point of how fast the wind is, where you have it located at. You see in this picture where my brother have had it put. Okay, it lasted quite a long time there. But it's just real hard and fast wind. Like a rolling air hits it. Okay. You look at the size of it, plastic and all that. And it even lasts through the winter. Like this. Okay, and you can see in there the plants, the rope panel. Other videos might have this as well and give you more information, ideas. Okay. Can you see 4 to 5 plants in it? I do. And this is real good plastic. It's not that real thin stuff either. Okay. And worn too. If you use coffee cans for stuff to put in, you know, like old coffee filters with coffee, and eggshells and all that. Well, I warn you, when it gets real nice and hot, it does go off. One time it sounded like a gunshot going off. But I bought some stuff, I did. I got wood chips and all that. And I found out that it had like something like roly-polies or something up into it. Thing of it is you want to check this stuff as well too. And other people on the internet always check too, to where you can verify things. And they say chopped up wood chips, you don't want anything that's been colorized to be put into your garden. The chemicals, the iodine chemicals, soaks into your soil and into your plants can cause problems. And the stuff that you're eating is that iodine too. Some people might have problems with that. Okay, and it's not good to have that in your garden. Wood chips. And they say too, you don't want to use pine needles in it as well. Something about, like, if you try to plant something next to a pine tree, some kind of stuff from the tree in the soil will stop, like, a tomato plant, onions, or anything to grow. So it's not a good idea. And this way, too, we decided to do it like this. It keeps animals up and out. You don't have salmonella poisoning going on in your garden when you have a raised bed like this. Okay. 2018, is to why we did this work. We wanted to see how it works, the progression and all that, how things work, the good and the bad. And we came across some stuff and all that. That we're going to be, the 2019, we're going to be adding to it. Newer ideals, new things. But check it out and all that. But you see how each of all this works, and you got rope and all that we did. We did it all like that. We want to make sure everyone understands. It's the thing too. You do got to watch out what you do put into your, when you do grow stuff. Because it can do more harm than good too. Like, okay, within your area, you ask the farmers and all that, your insects, mosquitoes and all that, you might want to find out more about that in your area, because, when you do start growing, if you, like what I found out is certain plants have certain things about where it helps fend off insects, okay? Do implement that into your garden when you start growing, because it helps out in other ways too. Alright? And with doing that, you'd be surprised on how much you get. And yeah, and look at the color of the leaves. Like if you got like little dots or brown edges on them, okay, and find out if you need male and female of that certain plant when you buy or you grow. And if you have to pollinate yourself, they always say you can get like a little small paintbrush and do it. And well, that's pretty neat if that really, I've never have done it, but if I have to, well, at least I know, okay, but I would have to figure out, but always find out what kind of plants, if it takes male and female, or what, and how, and zone, and all that. But you see, we got all that plastic, and we made up, but it really does help out in the long run, too. Because what we did one year is, right after fall hit, roller-till it and all that, put that fertilizer down. For the next year, we put the plastic back down. Deeply surprised to us is when we open up the put holes in the plastic just to get it ready to be planted, put this plant in. It was nice and thick and had a lot of water to it. So when we put our plants in, the plant soil absorb up the water, and it saved us money as well in our water bill, because it was about 2 months at the beginning of spring. Well, after the cold spell, when you do post a plant, well, it does help quite a bit. It saved us quite a bit of money. Plus, like I said, no insects or anything. And you put like old leaves and all that. That make a little hole, bury a big old pile of it under there, and then put smooth it all out. I had a flat garden with plastic flat. Make sure it's tight fit to the ground. No air, no pockets. Let's do it like that. And how I did is I took a flap of just the grass, cut, took the shovel, made sure the black grass was flipped over all the way around on all four sides, cut that plastic where it fits that size, take and start from one corner and worked all the way around. By the time I got done, I had a nice fit, tightened area of plastic, and with the snow and ice, it built up water there. And I was really surprised too. You take Brussels sprouts and you can let it grow through winter, okay? Because my mom, she had a Brussels sprout. It was a good 8 to 9 foot tall in her yard with plastic. Okay, so that was right off, really surprising to everyone. Okay, and you always make sure that it's nice and tight, and check if you have like rocks in your yard, or like in some places, like around where I live, in different zones for in different type of climate and different soil things. Okay, that's what we come across coal in our yard. We do. So we know we have to watch out for that. Okay? And people that, and another good thing, what you're doing is, if you know people's been dumping stuff before you have your piece of property, all you're redoing is you're rebuilding the soil back up to where it can support better grass in your yard. But then you're getting rid of a lot of the junk out of your yard too. And, okay. So, yeah. This is year 2018 going into 2019 with all newer and better ideas on how to perform, make our garden better. Make it, we'll see how it works on how it performs, the garden performs, quantity, color, and all, and how, like, okay. Now, has anyone ever grew, like, certain plants would you be seeing coming up in our garden channel? Okay, if you have seen them, if you have grown them, how do they perform for you, and where? We would like to know what zone, if you're in, like, okay, what better way? Okay, if you got light brown soil, like, well, if your soil is like clay, dark but loose, or in between both of them, Okay, let us know. All right. Because because we would like to find out what better way of to make our garden work just as good as well too. Okay, and and you can tell why we say make sure your plastic's down, because you can see the ruffles and all that. If you don't watch out, you can get that air blowing through, or even worse too. Because when my brother took up the plastic, okay, before he did, with big bulges all over the place, that plastic was down on the ground until 2019, a few weeks before spring started, while onions or garlic. Okay, you'll be seeing that later on in some other videos. Okay. Check that out. Why my brother did what he did with wild onion or garlic. Okay. But they say bury the onion or garlic so far, you know, they were far, pretty far. You had to see the video. But they, the tops merge up on top, okay? Force the plastic up. So they got a pretty good strong side. Okay. But it's a good thing to find out in your area. Okay. And you might want to find out too what kind of what kind of things like horse's tail, okay, and wild onion or wild garlic in your yard, okay. And what else can you find as well and use it and grow it, okay? Because it might come in handy. You might be able to make, you got your seasoning like clovers. Have you ever took a clover and smelt it or taste it? It really does taste pretty good. Clovers do. Okay. You can make jam from it. Okay. I tasted clover and I'll say it's quite tasteful. It's good. Alright. Now, that's why you always want to check when you buy if you buy plastic, make sure you get the right type and the right size for what you want. And especially, okay. And well, everything else is. Well, and like certain plants as well has things for like fleas, ticks, mice. They don't like certain odor fragrances from certain plants. Okay, always check in on that as well. And you see how soil as well. Mushmelons sorts of things. Okay. Now, this is Robert Hansen. Okay. If, like, go to, if you want to, the other things we have is Earth. Go to Earth on Facebook. You'll be getting more as well. Robert Hansen's mobile advertising as well, okay? There's a few more. But to get more information or leave ideas now, okay? Let us know. Just leave messages down at the bottom, and well, if you like it, share the information with everyone that you do know, okay? And this 2019, let's see how it turns out, people, okay? Especially with the prices of whatever, however it goes. All right, thank you.